You're listening to Spring River Chronicle. Audio on the go.
First National Banking Company. Get checking that pays with Super Plus Checking at FNBC.
Vandals strike old Kirkima. Buildings defaced with obscenities, historical items damaged or destroyed. By Lauren Siebert. Old Kirkima Camp in Cherokee Village was vandalized January 7 by two juvenile males. I got a call about 1:20 p.m. on Saturday, Rob Driesel, a member on the board of directors for Old Kirkima, said. It was Guard Dogs Security, a local security company. Authorities were alerted when the camp's security system sent out an alarm. They said an alarm had gone off on one of the doors. They had already dispatched the police department, Driesel said. I went down there then, because the police had already apprehended the two vandals. Driesel continued, they wanted me to get down there with the key so I could unlock the buildings and see what other damage had been done. At first glance, the damage did not appear to be more than knocked over trash cans. However, as the camp was examined, the damages were found to be extensive. When we got to investigating the property and looking around, there was lots of graffiti, Driesel noted. They had graffiti the tongue and groove doors, graffiti bronze plaques that are going to have to be sent off and redone and put back into place. According to Driesel, almost every structure located on the 5-acre camp had been vandalized, and the dollar amount of the damage is still being assessed. Bill LeCount with WSL will be doing our estimate, but he hasn't had time to go look at the damages and give us an estimate yet, Driesel said. Crude obscenities, racial slanders, and sexually degrading phrases had been spray-painted on irreplaceable and historical architecture. They graffitied the old 97 bridge, which is a tribute to scouting. In itself, it's a gorgeous piece of artwork, Driesel said. Engraved bricks, which had been purchased by patrons in honor of former scout masters and relics of Boy Scout tradition, had been broken and defaced. One of the bricks they destroyed is part of our Kirkima Forever Foundation, Driesel said. To get one of those bricks lasered, someone had to give at least $1,000 to the camp. Windows had been broken out, and screens of doors were ripped out, revealing more graffiti at every turn during the search of the property. They had kicked in multiple doors and windows, and tore up some roofing, Driesel said. The damage was so much that as we got to looking at it, the sicker we got, and it came a point where we kind of shut down. According to Driesel, charges have been filed, and he hopes the juveniles will be sentenced to work out the debt at Old Kirkima. We would really like it if they were the ones to help take care of the camp for maybe even a year and learn what that camp is really all about. Although Old Kirkima had already had a security system in place, it has since been expanded, and plans are in place to look at the system further to make sure it is airtight. Our security system is in place, and we have video surveillance and the security system. The video is the one thing few people know where it is, Driesel said. As far as the alarm system, we have expanded that. There were some places they got into that we never had really thought about putting an alarm on, Driesel noted. Even though there is nothing of value in those places, maybe if we would have had them on there, they wouldn't have been able to do as much damage. Driesel stated that he felt this vandalism was proof of a need in the community for more youth activities. Even if funding is scarce, youth organizations are a vital part of any community. If we don't step up and start finding ways to fund these organizations to help these kids out, more of this is to come, Driesel said. The kids don't have anything to do and aren't learning any civic responsibility.
Thanks for listening to Spring River Chronicle, audio on the go. Be sure to subscribe to the paper and check us out online at myspringriver.com.